Thank you. thing's still recording, man. So where are we going?
We're going to a secret location where there's a black vulture's nest with two chicks.
Wow. Right or left?
No, keep on. Yeah,
just, I'm sure. Let's see where we are. Yeah.
The middle path.
Middle path.
Do it Dalai Lama style.
There, right.
I found the vulture's nest maybe like 2 months ago.
Wow.
And when I did, I immediately contacted Steve because I knew that he would be interested in checking it out. And so what we've done is we put trail cameras on it, and we have to go down every so often and do maintenance. And I didn't think of it at the time, but there is a somebody that lives near the location where the nest is, and they have a dog. And the dog was very curious about what I was doing, so it followed me down. So I realized that I had created like this sort of chain reaction where it was kind of going down to where their roost is.
Oh.
And we had to put up some chain link fence and like all this kind of stuff. And I know that you all are going to go down there.
Okay.
And so I just wanted you to kind of go down when we're going down to do like camera maintenance and that sort of thing, so you can kind of see the context. And,
perfect.
And plus, it's like a really amazing, you know, like once in a lifetime kind of experience.
Yeah. This is Steve. He's an extreme naturalist.
Yep.
Well, okay. I'll take that, sure.
Yeah, he's got his GoPro today.
Yeah, awesome. Good to go.
And by the way, I don't know if you noticed, but we're driving down here in a fully electric car. That's
yay,
right.
It's solar powered.
Yeah, this car is charged by the sun, so it runs on our nearest star.
I could have saved some of the sandwich so you guys could have some.
Oh, no, that's okay.
Even yeah.
We're good.
That's awesome.
So used to us by now, they don't seem to, it doesn't seem to bother them. They just sit in the tree and watch until we leave.
Okay.
Normally, yes, it would, but I think my hypothesis is anyway that this area has been occupied by humans for quite some time. coming and going, and the birds are used to that. So they see us as just part of the environment until, you know, they're given a reason otherwise. And so as long as we don't disturb them too much, clean up our mess, and treat them with respect, then I think they'll do the same for us.
Wow. Is that cool?
With them, because we can't live without animals, and they can live without us, but we can't live on this planet without the things animals do for us.
Right.
And nature. Yeah, apes and vultures and lions and bugs and worms and turtles and snakes, everything. It all works together in this thing called nature, and without it all working together.
And
even horses. Yeah, without it working together, though, we can't exist. We have to have nature, but nature doesn't need us.
Is that cool?
Yeah. Let me start the next card going and go over there. John and I are actually going to go down in that chute and see if there's a place to put a camera down there, because there's a tunnel that goes under the rock up to where they are now.
Right.
And it might be a really neat perspective.
Okay, cool.
Do that in just a minute. Unless you want to go look right now, this is almost ready for the next card to start downloading. This thing. I've got another one from the other camera.
There's
camera's set. First time, yeah. 3 weeks ago, so this is the third time.
So we'll just have to strap it to a rock and jam it up in that crack. Try to maybe point it up here, because I was hoping we could get some video of the parents if they hop up here.
Yeah,
it has a wider angle, so it should look really cool. Let me go up there again and see if there's any scat up there. There's a chick feather up here, so they have been up here. Either they've been here or they just floated up here.
And it is recording, so I think we're good to go here.
leave it there to see what happens. Because, you know, we'll be doing this for probably 4 or 5 more.
Oh, I gotta pack it up.
Thank you, though. I gotta pack stuff up. Cleaned up. We're all set up. Good to go.
exposure. Incredible wind out here.
Yeah.
You know, it's a special spot.
Yeah, totally.
And, you know, we find a lot of other bits and pieces of shards of arrowheads, grinding stones, that sort of thing, like just up here on the property, so we know they were up here.
This is a really special place.
Yeah.
So we're out on this rock right now looking for a vulture nest that's supposedly in this area. So we're going to go take a look and see if we can find it. It might be. How far down below us is the nest?
It's just up over here.
Oh, is it down under that?
Yeah, I mean, you have to kind of go through, but it's almost straight off of where the vulture is.
All right, well, let's go check it out. Lead the way. Jeez, down in there? Oh, here, I'm going to pass this over to you. Down in there, isn't there? You wouldn't want to slip.
No.
I mean, it hurt just a little for a moment. Here, I'm going to pass you this camera. Got it.
Okay, so there's this dead hemlock.
Yeah.
Bottom of the maple. See there it's going. Did you see it
coming? I saw it go in. I see it there. Okay, I can see him from here.
Yep.
See if I can zoom in. Yep, there's the vulture. I'm sure they know we're here now.
Yeah.
It's really hard to keep the camera steady with this wind. Dinosaur. Whoop.
This tree, see this scotch pine?
Yeah.
It's right out there. That tree's been that size ever since I was a kid.
Stunted because there's just no soil.
Yeah.
Wow.
But it's still always healthy. Looks like that still is green. Lost
That's
a
great.
Few branches. I almost felt like coming out here and putting some bone meal out for it.
Yeah, yeah. It probably would enjoy that.
Yeah, I think so.
Wow.
Nice hit of some like calcium. Coming down this way, just, you know, it's not really a cleared trail, so just kind of watch your step because of
the Yeah. End up sliding down the mountain.
Yeah. Yeah, you can. Okay, so.
Yeah, there's the cave.
Okay, so this rock right here,
yeah,
and at the very edge of that, it kind of comes out and then goes back under.
And that's where they are.
Yeah, it's just under there.
Okay. Shots. You want to get a few too?
Yeah.
I see a feather. See it?
Look at that. Yeah.
That's awesome.
When it clears out, I'll have to. Hopefully, there'll be some remnants of the eggs I grabbed.
Yeah. All right, I'm setting up the camera. Film while I do this. can see where I've set the camera up. Facing directly at the vulture nest. That's as close as I want to get. Hopefully they don't destroy it. Alright, I'm going to get out of here. I don't want to disturb this area too much. I don't know if I already have, but let's go. There's the parents. Thank you.
Listen to that. Did you hear that?
Yeah.
Somebody's upset. That was a hawk, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Man, they're really... Yeah. I think we're just going to have to leave them alone.
Okay.
Why don't we listen to that? Hang on.
All right, so we're coming back down to the vulture nest. It's been about a week, a little over a week, and we're gonna check on the chicks. They hatched a few days ago, and also change the memory card and batteries in the camera.
Awesome view today.
Yeah, look at that.
Source. Oh, that's so cool.
Well, at least we know they're getting a good feed.
Did you get that?
I got that. That was great. All right, I'm going to slip in and change the batteries. This is as close as I'm going to get. I'm about 10 feet away. They don't seem too concerned with my presence. What I'm more concerned with is the adults. Where are they? And I'm kind of worried about getting vomited on. All right, I better do this thing. Change the camera's position. Here it is. I didn't change it by much. Pretty much the original spot, but I angled it a little different. Okay, so I have rebuilt the camera's mount to hold it more steady so it doesn't tip. I've jammed a rock in up here. It should not move forward again. I wonder if they're just right around hiding. The parents could have been just right out of view around the other side of that rock.
Yeah, that's the same thing that they did last time. They had drawn back as opposed to going out of the branch.
I bet they were right there the whole time. Now they're probably back on the nest.
Yeah.
But that's one reason I have the camera on right now, so if they come back, it'll get shots of them. And of course, the rock we're on is an unnamed middle of nowhere rock that I will not give the name of. This place needs to be protected. So this is my Vulture Cam office setup here in the rain-soaked Vulture Cave. I'm transferring video and image files from this camera that we mounted here about a week ago. Then I'll walk down and take a look and see what John's doing. Getting some images. Let's take a look at these little guys. Oh, their feathers are growing out nicely. I don't know where the other one went. He's probably hiding on the other side of this one, but it's just so dark, it's hard to tell. It looks like they've been pulling a lot of lichen down in here. Some action has been moving lichen down here, and I would guess it would be them. Not quite sure why. Maybe they're bored with all this rain. Let's switch to night vision and see if that helps. Only a little bit.
uploading pictures. They're done from the card to the computer. And let's take a look and see, just out of curiosity, if we've got any good footage. Oh my gosh, look at that. Awesome. I think I'm going to tilt the camera down a little bit. So you can see if I bring it down a little, I can bring it down and bring the field of view down to about here. Oh, look at that. That little guy just squirted. Zoom for a little bit here. Oop. Oh, this is so cool. Wow, they're testing out their wings. Oh, so this is basically their little jungle gym, their little exercise area, to get ready for flight. Their feathers are growing out. They're using it like a little runway, this area in here. Because when we walked up this morning, there's tracks, and just tracks are everywhere. Yeah, I think if I tilt the camera down a little bit more, I'll get a little bit better field of view. Because they're kind of going back under the camera. So cool. And this area here seems very important to them. It's a nice flat spot, very dry, and they can jump and hop and stretch their wings. So cool. Look at them just hop and run. They're having so much fun. We're in a very sacred place for these animals, and I feel privileged that they're allowing us to do this without really having much problem with us. They just sort of wait for us to leave. They don't get upset, but we can tell. The parents don't really come around much anymore. I think the parents are just off hunting and then bring food back and leave their babies to grow up on their own. So they're all there. Okay, also over here, here's the camera. Camera set up. Batteries replaced. Filming now. I'm going to check the magnet and see if the angle is right. So, like I said, I need to tilt it down just a little bit. Maybe that'll be good. We'll see how that does. John's down here getting more pictures. Vultures in their little roosting area. Until it finishes recording, because if I don't and I just turn it off, it could render that last file unusable. Let's give it another few minutes. If you look down here, there's vulture tracks. They're everywhere through here because they've just been using this area as a playground, as you saw in the video. They're probably hopping around up here as well. They're probably going from these rocks, bouncing up there and then running all over the place. There might be tracks and scat up here. don't see any evidence that they've been up here. Although this looks like scat. Whitewashing. Vulture poop, yeah. Either the babies or the parents have been up here. Look at this.
Yep.
So they're probably hopping all through here. Some up here. Just checking the angle. I wanted to make sure it was still playing at this point, and then I'll leave. Oh yeah, that's perfect. See, there's the pointy rock. Okay, I think we're going to leave it right where it is. So we're going to see the pointy rock. There's the hole they come up. Right over there. Yep, that's perfect. Alright, I'm going to leave it there. John's working on trying to figure out a placement for the other camera to see if we can get some more wide-angle footage of the whole area to see if the vultures are using this ledge that I just explored a few minutes ago. Alright, so John and I are packing up because we have a new camera installed looking out this direction, filming this opening. That we have, as I showed before, some vulture sign, and you know, the little babies are probably going to be hopping up here and bouncing back and forth and testing their little wings out coming very soon. And then the other camera is set up, and I need to just turn this on. And we're good to go. Alright, there we go. That was just my backpack. Okay. All right, I'll give it a couple of seconds, and then I'm going to check it again to make sure it's actually recording.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Let me check this. And it is recording. All right, we're good to go. All right, let's go.